I first met His Holiness the Dalai Lama in 1992. He invited me to talk with him about the possibility of engaging in neuroscientific research with Tibetan monks, practitioners who have spent years training their mind. I began my career studying the disturbed mind. And when I met His Holiness for the first time, he challenged me in a very direct way, and he said, "Why can't you use the same tools of modern neuroscience that you've been using to study depression and anxiety and fear? Why can't you use those same tools to study kindness and to study compassion?" When we first proposed this, most people looked at us like we're absolutely nuts. But here's the experiment. What we do is we bring people into the laboratory and we put a kind of metal plate that we strap onto a person's wrist. And through this plate, we can circulate water very, very rapidly. And we can regulate the temperature of the water. And I could tell you that this is damn hot. It feels like it's burning your skin. So we just give them one experience of this so that they know what we're talking about. They have the direct experience. Then we bring them into the formal experiment and they're in the MRI scanner. And we tell them we're gonna give them two tones. When they hear one tone, which is a high-pitched tone, beep, then they know that in 10 seconds, they're gonna get zapped with this very painful stimulus. If they hear a low tone, boop, they know that they will just feel warm, but it won't be hot. Very simple. So we have people who've meditated and we have controls, people who've never meditated, their age and gender matched, and they go through this experiment. Now we know where in the brain the pain circuits reside, so we know exactly where to look. And when we look at those circuits in the non-meditating controls, the moment we present the high-pitched tone, beep, their brain responds as if it received the actual pain. So nothing's happened other than they got a tone, but their brains are responding as if they got the heat. When you do that with the meditators, they receive the tone, beep, nothing happens. There's absolutely no significant change in the pain matrix. They're flat. Then when the actual heat comes on, both groups respond. But then as soon as the pain goes off, the meditators come right back down to baseline, whereas the controls persist. Their pain circuits are still reverberating. It's as if they can't shut them off. They're ruminating about the pain. The conclusion that our work has led us to, very simply, but we think it's a very radical conclusion. And that is that well-being is a skill. Well-being can actually be learned, it can be nurtured, and it's a skill that can enable us to live a happier life. When human beings first evolved on this planet, none of us were brushing our teeth. This is a learned behavior. It's not part of our genome. And if we spent even the short amount of time that we spend every day brushing our teeth, nurturing our mind, this world would be a very different place.